Each year, the National Social Security Fund disburses at least 1.7 trillion shillings in retirement benefits to at least 72,000 retirees. A huge portion of the beneficiaries, about 60%, get below 10 million shillings. These, however, have continued to misuse their savings, according to a new report.
What to take out from that is that the extension of the dependence burden into retirement will only perpetuate the cycle of dependency. Because what happens if you're stuck? You misuse the money somehow, and now you have to survive.
Findings indicate that most retirees do not consider obtaining financial training or advice before withdrawing their savings. Wrong investment choices are the other reason cited.
I just want to share my story related to this. Like I said, I'm eligible, but I told myself, let me first cool down. Let me not go for this thing now because I am not yet ready. And so my birthday falls at the end of the year, 31st December. So 31st December, I became eligible for this package. And so, of course, I invited friends. We celebrated. And so mid-January, a friend of mine sends me a message and says, Rosemary, I have a bit of a financial issue. And so please help me. I need some money from you. And so she puts such a big figure. 300 million. And I'm like, are you crazy?
And so the National Social Security Fund is now considering mandatory financial training as a pre-benefit preparation mechanism to ensure that the beneficiaries use the money on profitable projects.
And the reason why that is important is, if we are going to develop our country, part of what we can do for ourselves, and for ourselves, is to get on this savings culture. Because in it, as a nation, it lays the foundation for our own development agenda, that some of the things we do, we can do for ourselves instead of running all the time to what we call development partners. And they put all kinds of terms on us, and we panic. So you think about building a nation for your country, for your children, for your future. Saving the next cycle is good for you. It's good for the family.
New findings indicate that 15 million Ugandans have no savings to retire to. Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.